of course, I can't stop raving about Gentleman's Guide because it's so Gilbert and Sullivan, since the topic has now just come up again.
Yeah.
It's so British, and it's still going strong on Broadway a year after you've won the Tony. Congratulations.
Yeah. We just, I guess it's been 604 performances as of this morning, but who's counting?
Well, so, yeah. But you knew.
Who's counting? Oh, of course. No, you know, that's what I do at the end of my day, is I read all the performance reports, you know, so if I'm directing something.
What are performance reports?
Performance reports is, it tells you how the show went every single night.
And who writes them?
The stage manager. So at the end of the day, I read the ones from Hartford Stage, and I read the ones from Broadway.
Yeah.
And then if I've done something else, so at times, like I read three, you know,
but
performance reports from three different cities. And then, you know, if they're good, I go to sleep. And if they're bad, I need a drink. You know, so
what if you read a performance report and can you judge what's going on from the...
You have to have good stage managers, great ones. You have to have people who...
Nobody ever talks about this, you know.
Oh, sure. No, you are. Well, you know, like, one of the things that I look at is how long things are.
Ah.
Like, for comedy...
The running time.
Yeah, the running time. You know, for comedy, you know that if they're adding a lot of time, something is off. You know, and it better be because the audience is laughing uproariously.
Okay.
Because that's the only reason why you should stretch.
Okay.
Otherwise, keep it going.
So where are we right now in the lovely Hartford stage? You're set, the stage itself, we can't, you know, get in there because there's construction going on, drilling and all kinds of stuff.
Yeah. Well,
for Kiss Me, Kate, which is opening is it opening?
May 14th through June 14th.
Okay,
that's easy to remember. It's a month. It's exactly a month. And then we go to San Diego. The outside, you know, we're doing the final phase of the renovation, and they're putting the set in.
The theater's being renovated as we see.
Yeah.
On top of everything else,
sure.
We're renovating the theater.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
It'll all be done by the end of the summer.
So. It's a massive amount of... It's like Lincoln Center up here, I'm telling you guys. I mean, it's just... And the work, of course, is exceptional. I guess when you're out of town, you have to try harder. Because every time I've come up here, I've been astounded by the talent
and the work
on stage.
I think it's probably what every artistic director around the country wants, is just to bring the best for their audience and for their city.
And everybody wants to work with you now, since the Tony.
You know what's interesting?
That must have changed.
Here's what's interesting is, like, last year, I was in the room with Terrence McNally, Lynn Ahrens, and Stephen Flaherty, and actors walking into audition for this workshop, they were all congratulating me, and they looked at each other, and they're like, well, we have the awards too, and stuff, and I was like, give it a year. I was like, now somebody, in a few weeks, it's going to be somebody else's turn, and some of that fuss goes down, so, you know, it's... I'm just the newbie, but it's nice. I'm very appreciative and very humble about it. So,
yeah. it was a tough win last year too. It was a fight to the... I won't mention the other contentious names.
Oh,
but
I
gave you as much publicity as anybody possibly could in New York.
No. You know, Cheetah Rivera said something so beautiful in New York Times. You know, she says that nobody gets into it for awards, and then, you know, everybody gets into it for other reasons. But, you know, but I won't lie, in the Broadway arena, you know, we would not be running if the show had not won the Best Musical Tony.
That was an extraordinary
There are shows that were nominated and they're still running. Gentleman's Guide, you know, it's...
It changed the box office, it changed
your career, it changed everything.
I
imagine that, you know, there are things, you know, especially for family audiences, you know, and they can keep running year after year, a show about a man who kills his entire family that ends...
Well, that's a family show.
Well, that ends in a three-way, you know, it's not exactly like... You can't advertise it as family.
I was watching that scene over and over again the other day.
It did very well at
the
Christmas.
The trio scene,
yeah.
Yes.
It did very well at Christmas time, and I think my theory is that everybody just wants to, you know, around Christmas, everybody, like, has that moment when they want to strangle their family and stuff. shopping and everything. So I think we're a good Christmas show. It's good antidote.
Well, and it was so well, I mean, I should also congratulate you when, you know, it was so well chosen and so well presented on the Tonys that night, which of course you will have seen because everyone can see the Tonys.
Sure.
Picking that scene out of the whole play of the trio with the two women and Bryce in the middle. Incredible direction.
And then we did a little bit with Jefferson.
Yes, that was adorable.
Changing clothing. The thing that's interesting, you know, about the show is that, oddly enough, none of the other numbers make sense out of context.
Interesting.
On camera.
Yeah.
So the thing is, you know, with the theory behind musicals is that, like, you know, every number has to be connected to, you know, the story intricately. But when you go on camera and you have to take it out of context, that just doesn't work. So sometimes the better the structure, the less camera and ready, friendly moments you have. So with that trio, that makes sense. You know, it's like a farce unto itself.
It's like
instantly
two girls, one guy, you get it. You know, it's like a simple
thing
that just can be taken in. And everybody, all the people in the world that watched the Tonys saw it. And
It was fun. You know, the first time we put together that trio, I'm never going to forget.
I should mention but it's Bryce Pinkham and Lisa.
Lisa O'Hare did it, and
Lauren Worsham with three wonderful actors.
And now we have Jeff Crady and Scarlett Strelan from London, who's a wonderful English actress, and Catherine Walker. We have three talented, gorgeous people in the new incarnation, so it's good.
And now Bryce doesn't have a job, just saying, but anyway, as of Sunday. But
he's talented. Something will come up.
So, yes. Well, it was interesting to see him at Darko, since you haven't seen it, in a straight role. I mean, a straight play, excuse me. The role is gay role.
Gay role in a straight play.
And he's straight. So, I mean, it was, you know, that's based on Christopher Durang, and I knew, you know, I felt that he did it with so much warmth and so much love. It was so different than anything I had seen before. I didn't like the original production. I thought it was cold. And I knew Wendy very well, and I'm just shocked at people saying it's dated, it's not relevant, it's, you know. But I felt it was, and I constantly have been writing about it, but, you know, I do what I can, you know.
Sure.
Some people listen, some people don't, and I don't run the drama desk, I'm just a voter, but I'm not on the committee, but you did quite well last year with the drama desk.
Yeah, it was a good evening, and...
Which is where we spoke last.
Yes, I remember. And it was wonderful because my friend Marge Champion was there that night, and I got to thank her in person.
Wow, of Marge and Gower Champion?
Yeah,
wow.
Marge, you know, she kind of...
She's still with us.
Yeah, Marge pretty much discovered me, you know, I got my first break because of Marge.
Oh, how did that happen?
Oh, she gave me a Boris Segal Fellowship at the Williamstown Theater Festival.
Oh, my God.
And she became a friend after that summer. She saw my work, and she was the one who told me to direct musicals, and she told me I should direct a new musical. So it was great that, you know, 95 years young, that she was in the audience that night when I got to thank her.
But your Hamlet was pretty astounding, I have to say.
Thanks.
It was just on the same level as Gentleman's Guide. It was great Shakespeare as well as Gentleman's Guide. It's a great musical. And I felt you were innovating Shakespeare and changing it in all different ways. And that things, you know, they cut Shakespeare constantly. Mm-hmm. And there were things in it, like I think there were the two grave diggers.
Yeah.
Right? Which nobody ever does that. They don't know.
I think it's usually done with two.
No. It's usually done with one.
Oh, okay.
And so you did it with two, and there was a lot more of the text there
that
is relevant
about
Ophelia, like you know.
Sure.
There was a great line. I can't remember the line, but...
It's fun, you know, to mix it up. It's fun to go from classical plays to new works, from musicals and to plays to doing opera. So
I guess
I have a short attention span because I mix it up a lot. So it's
great though. It shows your versatility
and whatever I've done before. Like I love going in a wildly different direction, you know. So That's fun.
And everybody.
And I'm doing a stage thriller next, you know, in the fall. I'm doing Rear Window. So
oh, yes, tell us about that.
Yeah. Oh, it's a new adaptation.
Of Hitchcock's.
Not Hitchcock's. It's based on the story by Cornell Woolrich, who wrote the original story.
Right.
The Hitchcock based the movie. So it follows the story much more closely. And it's really interesting. I think people will be really surprised. And that's all I'm going to say.
Well, I know a little bit about, I think, Cornell Woolrich. Did you know that he was the character that supposedly in the movie Hitch, I don't know if you saw that, in which Hitch is, Helen Mirren in the movie, Hitchcock's wife is supposedly having this sort of thing with. He was one of the people that wanted
No, he was gay, so he was very...
Yeah, well, I knew that, but whole thing was a bit off that way.
But it would be silly to do Rear Window unless there was a very different take. And when I read the play version,
I watched that constantly. Yeah. All of Hitchcock I watch over and over. And now I think we're almost have to say goodbye.
Yeah.
Are you going to have lunch or go back to rehearsal?
Back to rehearsal. It's Kiss Me Kate. It's relentless.
It's relentless. Kiss Me Darko. I'm going to end it this way. Oh.
Thank you so much. Thanks for coming up to
Hartford. It was a great honor.
Excellent.
Thank you, sir.
Pleasure.